the simultaneous mm-hmm. is necessarily acoustic, and anything sequential is necessarily visual. Now this is not a, this is structurally.
I think I wouldn't want to make music in a way where I only use the obvious tools.
Like you can control how it can sound and how you want to play like the chords for it or how you want to play rhythmically. And that really did a lot to me because this freedom gave me so much ways of being creative. And that was the time when I really understood that music can be something very free.
For us, everything started with a grand piano.
I started to play the piano when I was 5 years old. My parents made me. And I always had problems with the classical approach, so I had a teacher who made me play things exactly like they were written. And I always wanted to add my own personality, but they would never allow it. And then I stopped playing the piano for some years and picked it up again when I discovered this world of jazz music where you could bring in your own personality. And when I met Lucas, we like hung out. And at one point I was thinking, why not try to make music with him? And I knew that he always was the kind of guy who was really into computers. We started to experiment and we came up with things that I didn't know that would be possible.
I think I never really saw myself as a musician. In the beginning I was more into the technical part of things because I was working as a software engineer, but like the music gave me much more freedom because you don't get bug reports from your listeners. Yeah, early on we had this restriction that everything has to come from the grand piano, like we don't want to use synthesizers or pre-recorded sounds. And I came up with the idea of building some like hammers which can be attached to the piano, to the strings or the wooden and metal parts, so I can play the piano kind of like a drum machine. And suddenly I was able to play my own melodies and play beats. But I think for me personally it makes myself more proud if we can do it with this restriction. So it's kind of a challenge, I think.
So-and-so all changed my life. And their relationships, where they live, where they work.
And at some point, Errol moved to a different city and we had to find a new way to make music together. But restriction is always really inspiring because you have your limits and you have to come up with ideas to achieve something. And with all the unknown, we allowed ourselves to use pre-recorded sounds and build much more complex sounds, much denser and deeper compositions. But we still stick to the restriction that everything has to come from the grand piano.
For us, it's always about contrast. So we have the really like electronic sounds combined with the mellow, sometimes even romantic piano sounds. And the unknown is a contrast in itself. It has this sort of negativity. It can be something like threatening or you want to run away from it, but it also can be something positive and you take some sort of creativity out of it because you don't know what is going to happen, but let yourself just fall into it and see what comes out of it.
combining the accuracy of the machine and the beauty of human imperfection is very, very exciting. And All the Unknown is a really good analogy to what we try to explore.